Hi, I'm Kelly Collins. I'm here at Balance Health Center in Rittenhouse Square, Philadelphia, and I'm joined by Dr. Chris Bernabei, who specializes in chiropractic medicine. What kind of treatment do you give a patient maybe coming in complaining of any kind of back pain, mostly related to maybe some stress or headaches?
Mm-hmm. Well, we treat a large variety of different stress-related health problems, ranging from headaches to sciatic pain, totally different ends of the body as far as the pain and problems can go. We deal with headaches, dizziness, vertigo, sinus congestion, allergies, shoulder back problems, digestive problems, a wide variety of concerns you might traditionally seek care from a medical doctor.
What would be your first instinct as to treating a patient who comes to you, let's say like middle age? I don't know if it makes a difference, male or female. What would you do for them initially in a first examination?
Well, on an initial visit, which is usually the most important visit, where we find out the background of the past health history of the individual, more or less the problems or concerns that brought them there and how they got to be in that way. During the examination, we get involved in a range of movement testing, muscle testing, static and motion palpation, orthopedic tests, posture analysis, a variety and many different types of tests, really geared at trying to isolate and understand exactly where the problem stems from within their musculoskeletal system.
Where do you start?
Well, the first thing we really look at actually is the length of one leg relative to the other. Very commonly, people come in and one leg or the other will be shorter, and it could range anywhere from a 16th of an inch on up to even a half an inch. What this really represents is a structural misalignment of the body, and it helps us to gain understanding as to whether the problems are beginning at the foundation of their spine, as far as the hips and pelvis, or whether the problems are beginning at the top of their spine in the upper neck or upper cervical region, as we refer to it.
Would you be able to demonstrate on me
if
I
absolutely
lay down and hopefully my legs are not too disproportionate, but maybe you can just give an example of, I guess, you know, where you would, what kind of pain assessment like you would give to somebody like me?
Okay, so if you sit up nice and tall, please, turn your head to the right. And turn your head to the left, please. And back to the center. So you went just shy of 60 degrees going to the right, a little bit more than 60 degrees to your left. So more or less symmetric. However, ideally we're looking between 85 and 90 degrees. Now if you look towards that wall for a moment, and please tilt your head up like you're looking up at the ceiling, and tilt your head forward like you're looking down at the floor, and relax. Okay, so the forward tilt, you went 55 out of an ideal of 60, and the tilt backwards, you went 25 out of a probable 50 degrees. Now last one, if you continue to look that way, and you're just going to tilt your head to the side like you're putting your left ear on your shoulder, please. Okay, that's fine, 30 degrees, go to the other side, please. And a little bit better there at 37 degrees. Okay, relax. And for those, we're looking for an ideal of 45 degrees. So a bit of restriction up here in the neck. Now we're going to do a few orthopedic tests here. As I press down into the shoulder, does that make things feel better, worse, or no change relative to your neck or headaches?
Better.
Okay, that's a good sign. Do it for this side, any better, worse, or no change?
Better.
Good. So I press down, how's that one affect things?
Possibly worse.
Okay, and the last one here, we're going to lift up. Not so much the pressure of my thumbs, but the stretch.
That's probably worse.
Okay, stand up straight, please. And bring the table up so you can climb on, and then we'll lower you down into a line here. Let's just lean in.
Okay, so now.
Okay.
Like this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I just didn't want to
fall. You just relax, let me do a little work here. Ready?
Yeah.
So just wait for the table to stop. Once that does stop at the bottom, you can feel free to move your arms around if you'd like to get more comfortable. Okay, so if you just relax there. Now, as we look here, your right leg is about a quarter inch shy of even, or in other words, your right leg is short. If you let your knees bend, the legs level out. So what that suggests is there is a misalignment over here at the right sacroiliac joint. A bit tender in there at all?
Maybe a little.
maybe a little, but the other side. Not the same, better or worse, or no change, or no different?
It might be better.
Mm-hmm.
It's harder, though.
Mm-hmm. If I bend the knee, how does this affect the way the lower back or pelvis feels? Does it change?
Not at all.
Okay. Same thing for this leg. Any different there?
Maybe a little bit better.
Okay. Now keep your knees straight. Lift this entire leg as high as you can, please. Try to keep your knees straight.
Oh,
lift the whole leg. Yes.
Oh, like that.
Yeah,
sorry.
Exactly. That's okay. And back down, please. Try the other side. And back down. Okay, so they were about the same. Yeah. So please turn your head to the right. Please turn your head to the left. And back to the center, please. Okay. And as I feel the spine here, we're going to be checking the alignment of the bones. We're also feeling for the movement of those segments relative to each other, where we're looking for fixations and blockages in the motion, which we refer to as a subluxation or a misaligned vertebra. So the problem over here with the right iliac is that this bone here has tilted backwards slightly. The bone at the other end is your leg socket, so it causes the leg to appear short compared to the left. The issue here is that when you're standing and sitting, you're hips are leaning into that short leg, and it forces the muscles on the opposite side of your spine here to react and pull in order to compensate for that hip being misaligned. The end result is that these bones begin to overcompensate and they pull too far to your left. An example of that would be right about there. As we go further up, another one here going the other direction. Put a bit of blockage here in the mid-back. If any of this pressure is too tender or sore, let me know. All the nerves in your body fit in three categories. We have sensory nerves, which are the most obvious, and they will typically relate pain or numbness to the area that they relate to when they become pinched or irritated. The motor nerves affect the muscle functions and cause muscles to overcontract or not contract enough. And those are sometimes obvious. The third group of nerves, which are the least notable as far as what you experience, but probably the most important relative to your well-being, are the visceral or internal organ nerves. And those allow the brain to regulate and coordinate all the different functions of the internal organs relative to keeping you healthy and alive. Please turn on your back.